مرحبا بكم our dear students in our 11th episode from Learning Arabic, our YouTube channel. It's my pleasure to be with you today, and inshallah we're going to continue as I told you before last week, the letter Kha. Kha letter, we said Aleph, B, T, Th, Jim, Ha, Kha. Kha, we took it in the front and as a first letter. Today, inshallah, we're going to take it as a letter in the middle, a letter in the end. Let's see the first one. But before we do that, we have to write something here. I wish the camera can follow me to go with this, how I write the letters, because many students actually, they ask me to do that. I go this way, I say, here is the B. And seen and meem. I put kasra under the ba, the sukun in the top of the seam, kasra under the meem, then the alif like that, the lam I go like that, and I go this way and I make the ha marbuta. Here is a wasla, here is a shadda, and this bismillahi. This is the wasla here to connect the letter. This one alif with the meem, bismillahi, not to say bismi and illahi, bismillahi, and then ar-Rahman, alif, lam, re, ha, meem, noon, wasla here, shadda, fatha, arra, sukun here, dagger alif here, kasra, ar-Rahmani, if I want to say it together, bismillahir-Rahmani, and the last word here, alif, Lam, Re, Ha, Ye, Meem. Alif, it's a wasla, shadda. And go like that. So, I like to be careful with this one to tell you that when we start any work with the Arabic stuff, we have to say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. When we start to eat, we say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. It's a culture. You have to go with the culture. Don't put anything with the religion or something. It's culture. Before you drive your car, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Before you open your book to study, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So you have a bay, seen, meem, alif, lam, lam, he marbuta, alif, lam, re, ha, meem, noon, alif, lam, re, ha, ye, meem. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Then I have this word now to use it, which is Aleph, Lam, Ye, Waw, Meem. Sukun here, Ye, Fatha, Sukun here. Look at this Sukun, and look at this Sukun. Regular Arabic, we use this only when you read or you write Quran. Al-Yawm. Al-Yawm. I'm going to say, for example, today is Aleph, Lam, Aleph. Hamza, al a, then the re with the sukun, then the ba, then the ayn, then the alif, then the hamza. Together will be al arbi'a. Can you say it, both of you? Al arbi'a. I have students here, my dear students. They watch this class. Al arbi'a, it's number four in the week from the number arba'a. Al arbi'a. Always. Also, this word alif lam te alif re ye kha. I put the shadda here. Lam non-pronounced but written at-tariq. Say it. At-tariq. At-tariq has two meanings: dates or history. When I say adrus at-tariq fi jamiat al-qahira, I study history at Cairo University. Adrus at-tariq fi jamiat Tokyo. I study history at Turkey, but tariqh al-yawm, we start today with ithna ashar, / ithnan, because February month is number two, and the 2020, it's a piece of cake. I like to make it. Ithnan sifr, ithnan sifr. See, ithnan sifr, ithnan sifr. Somebody gonna tell me, it's not the way you say it in Arabic. How you say it? Alfayn wa ashreen. But my students are still in the beginning. I have to tell them, ithnan sifr, ithnan sifr. And the letter meem. I will come back to this one. I make it in Arabic now. Ithna ashar. اثنان الفين وعشرين ميلادي. It's a ميلاد المسيح. The birth of the Messiah, Jesus. Peace on him. Prophet Jesus. So if I make like that, say after me. اليوم. الأربعاء. التاريخ. ميلادي. So for my students, to watch us, our viewers now, you have to know. That's what we have to. If you have a chance, of course, you have the program. You can see it again and again and again. Even if I erase it now, but no, I'm not going to erase it. We're still with the letter Aleph, Lam, Dal, Re, Sin, Ad-Dars. We say Ha, Re, Fe, Harf. Harf in Arabic, in English, is a letter. Harf, letter. Letter what? This one. Say Kha. As a word, Kha. As a letter, sound, Kha. With the Fatha, Kha. With the Kasra, Khi. With the Dhamma, Khu. So it's a Kha. But as a word, Kha. Harf al Kha. The last week we took the Kha in the beginning. Now we're going to take it in the middle. In the middle, I have these words. For example, Aleph, Hamza, Fatha, Kha, Sukun, Be, Aleph, Re. For my viewers, they like my handwriting. I show it to you and I ask our beloved person in the camera to focus about it. Akhbar, say Akhbar. Akhbar is a news. Akhbar. And don't mix between Akhbar and Akbar. Akbar. No, Akhbar, news. In Arabic language, news, plural and singular. Khabar, one piece of news, as I mentioned last week. Akhbar, the letter Kha in the middle here. The second word is Ye. Fatha, Kha, Sukun, Re, Dhamma, Jim. Ye with the Fatha, Ya. Kha with the Sukun, Yakh. Re with the Dhamma, Ru, Yakhru. Jim, Yakhruj. Yakhruj, he goes out. Yakhruj and raise min al bayt. Takhruj, Barbara, min al bayt. Takhruj, Ka, min al dar. Yakhruj, Ahmad, min al maktab, the office. So, Kha in the middle, Kha in the middle. Another word, Mim, with the Fatha. Kha, with the Sukoon. Be, and Zain. Makhbaz, say, Makhbaz. Makhbaz, Makhbaz, yani baker. The place we bake the bread. So the place we bake the khubz, we make it in the makhbaz. Again, akhbar, yakhruj, makhbaz. Let's make one beautiful sentence about this. Here is the sentence. What is the sentence? I, alif, hamza, fatha, a, shin, te, re, ye, Alif, Hamza, Fatha, Shin, Sukun, Ash, Te, Ashta, Ri, Ashta, Ri, Yi, Ashtari, I buy. New word for you. Ashtari, Al-Kitab. Ashtari, Al-Khubz. I buy bread. Huh? Ashtari, Al-Falafel. Ashtari, Al-Kabab. Ashtari, Al-Ka'k. Ashtari, what? Alif? La, Kha with the Dhamma, and Be, then Zain. Al-Khubz, Al-Khubz, big where? In Al-Makhbaz, related to each other. Ashtari Al-Khubz, from where? Min. Min what? Alif and Lam, Mim, Kha. Be and Zain Al-Makhbaz. Let's read the sentence again. All of you repeat after me. My viewers repeat after me. My students here repeat after me. Ashtari.
Ashtari.
Al-Khubz.
Al-Khubz.
Min.
Min.
Al-Makhbaz.
Al-Makhbaz.
But if I want to read it together, اشتري الخبز من المخبز. اشتري الخبز من المخبز. The more you connect the words together, the more you reach what we call it superior in reading according to the level. You have a superior reading for level 1, superior reading for level 2, superior reading for level 3. We're still in 1. اشتري الخبز من المخبز. And in last 2 minutes, I'm going to give you 3 words for the kha in the end. Here is the one. Number 1. Meem. Noon. Alif. Kha. Say, munakh. It's a wither. If I said munakh, it's a wither. If I said manakh with the fatha, the place which the camel lay down. Very interesting culture. Say, munakh. Munakh forecast, for the forecast. The next one for this, meem, ta, be, kha. Matbakh. Say, matbakh. Kitchen. Munakh, wither, matbakh. Kitchen. And the other word here is ye fa be kha. Ye with the fatha, ta with the sukun, be with the dhamma, and I read this word yatbukh.
Yatbukh.
If you have yatbukh, you need the matbukh. I said yatbukh Andres fi al matbukh. If it's a Barbara or Ka, Tatbukh, feminine. I'm going to change it to Tatbukh. I'm going to put the sentence here. Tatbukh. And the word is Zainab. Zainab, it's a name, Arabic name. Zainab, or Barbara, or Ka, or Yasmin, or Caroline. Tatbukh Zainab fi, what does that mean, fi, in or at? Al-matbukh, alif, lam, mim, ta, be, kha. I know I took more time, but so, akhbar, yakhruj, makhbaz, ashtari, al-khubz, min al-makhbaz, I buy the bread from the bakery. Because one of my students, he said, can you put the English next to the words? I'm not one of the people who support this way, either translation or transliteration, but I try my best to read it for you with the meaning to know. Munakh, wither. Matbakh, kitchen. Yatbukh, he cooks. Tatbukh, he cooks. Change ya to ta, change it to feminine. Tatbukh Zainab. So Zainab cooks. Fi, in or at, al-matbakh, the kitchen. So with this one, our dear students, our dear viewers, we reached the end for this episode. I hope you enjoy the class. Just I want to remind you to subscribe for our program. I don't like to say that from the beginning, but better to subscribe, because the more we have subscribers, you can inshallah receive this. Also, wait for our Arabic conversation with Ahmed Isawi to talk a lot, which is going to come soon inshallah in app. Shukran wa ila liqa. Ma salama. Ma salama. It's a pleasure.